Effective communication and social networking. Importance of ongoing two-way communication with booster members. The key to success for any booster club is the participation of its members, so it's extremely important to keep them all well informed. This goes beyond simply providing them with access to your meeting minutes and bylaws. You must be willing to accept input from your club's members, including criticism when necessary. Members should feel welcome to offer such input without fear of reprisal or animosity. You should also stress to members that the best opportunity to bring up items of discussion is at your monthly meetings. All members, students, and other interested parties should be encouraged to attend regularly so that their voices may be heard. This also provides another advantage to the executive board: the ability to solve problems and make decisions that the president or executive board have been unable to finalize. The tougher the decision, the greater the benefit of expanding the discussion. There may be other aspects of the issue brought up that have not yet been considered, and the burden and responsibility of the final decision is shared among the majority when a motion is presented on the floor and a vote of the General Assembly either passes or opposes the motion. Maintaining an effective website. One issue small businesses and nonprofits alike often struggle with is creating or upgrading to a well-designed, effective website. This is usually because finding an inexperienced, reliable web developer can be difficult. And when you do find one, they're either too expensive for a nonprofit organization operating under a strict budget, or not always available when you need them to post content, add features, or redesign the site when needed. Without providing current and accurate information at all times, members and other visitors will quickly find it not worth the effort of visiting it regularly. So it is important to always have a reason for interested parties to visit on a regular basis. It's particularly easy to keep it current if you provide a way for all executive officers and committee chairpersons to post content when needed. You should assign one knowledgeable person to be your website committee chair or webmaster, but there's no need to rely on them solely to post, approve, or edit content. The remaining members of the website committee or one or more executive officers should also be able to monitor and moderate website content regularly. The best option is to use a content management system, or CMS, like WordPress, Drupal, Joomla, or Squarespace as the back end of your website. WordPress is recommended because it is absolutely free and there are plenty of plugins, themes, and widgets freely available. This means the only cost the club has to bear is the annual domain name registration and monthly hosting fees, which vary depending on your chosen registrar and hosting service. It is highly recommended that you purchase the .com, .net, and .org top-level domains, or TLDs. One of these can point to your hostname server where your website is actually stored, while the other two simply forward to that one. This way, visitors can use any of the three to access your website. Recommended features for your website include a blog feed on your homepage presenting the latest content, a page that provides a digital archive of public documents like your bylaws, meeting agendas, financial treasury reports, General Assembly, and meeting minutes, your band student handbook, and any other files you want members and others to have easy access to. Links to useful school and district resources such as the NISD background check form, links to other booster websites, information on charitable donations, and a method to make donations online. A way to accept online payments for fundraisers, booster polo shirts, and event registrations. Contact form where visitors can submit questions, comments, etc., and a sign-up form for your email distribution and newsletter subscription lists. Tip: be sure to comply with the CAN-SPAM Act when using email to communicate or distribute information. Although the letter of the law indicates that it applies to commercial emails, it makes no exceptions for business-to-business emails or nonprofit organizations. This means that you may be subject to penalties of up to $16,000 per instance. The Federal Trade Commission, FTC, provides a simplified summary of the law on their Bureau of Consumer Protection Business Center website. The following are the main requirements they list. 1. Don't use false or misleading header information, from, to, reply to, and routing information, including originating domain name and email addresses. 2. Don't use deceptive subject lines. 3. Identify the message as an advertisement if it is one. 4. Tell recipients where you're located. Use an email signature on all messages. 5. Tell recipients how to opt out of receiving future emails from you. 6. Honor opt-out requests promptly. And 7. Monitor what others are doing on your behalf. Using third-party distribution services do not relieve you of your responsibility to comply with the law. You should visit the FTC website referenced for a more complete explanation of these requirements. Most importantly, your website should describe your booster club and its mission statement, goals, purposes, etc. You should also provide contact information for each executive board officer. Domain-based, aka vanity, email addresses can be used to help protect the private email addresses of each officer. If using Google Apps, it is possible to set up Google Voice accounts for each officer if you would like to post phone numbers as well. Google Voice numbers can be forwarded to secondary numbers like cell phones and home phones, and also provide a cloud-based voicemail system, allowing users to be contacted without exposing their personal numbers. Google Voice apps are also available for smartphones and add the ability to place outgoing calls using the Google Voice number. And one thing we recommend is to view the rest of our website, jjmustangband.net, and use that as a guideline to see the different areas that we have and how we lay out our website. Active social media campaign. In the digital mobile world we now live in, most use at least one online social network, if not three or more. Each platform focuses on different areas of social communication, from basic conversation to distributing short updates, publicizing your location, sharing multimedia, identifies areas of interest online, managing groups with like interests, providing advertisements, or even business networking. Sometimes multiple platforms are used in conjunction with each other to utilize many of these features. And this is because each platform is used in different ways. The most popular platform of all is Facebook because it provides the most options for these needs. So it is a no-brainer that it is an effective two-way communication service. The other platforms warrant fair consideration based on the needs of your booster club. Many metrics are available online that identify the demographics of social networks, and they offer an interesting insight on the platforms most popular among users in certain age groups, genders, and levels of income. For example, a recent Pew Research study found that 71% of internet users use Facebook, a good 49 points higher than the runner-up, LinkedIn. Silicon Alley Insider recently charted data from users of the popular Add to Any mobile app, which enables users to share items from other apps. That shows Facebook is the most popular share destination at 24%, with email and Twitter being the runners-up at 11.1% and 10.8% respectively. In both cases, the gap in usage statistics is very telling. Whichever social networking media sharing solutions you use, it is important not to let them drive visitors away from your website. All your means of communication should complement each other and constantly send visitors back and forth. This helps to promote all solutions and validate their relativity and reliability to search engines, visitors, and marketing partners and supporters. Analytics. Just as usage statistics help us evaluate our options when considering what social networks to utilize, statistics on how your website is being found and viewed can also prove useful. The easiest way to collect such data is with Google Analytics. With Google Analytics, all you need is to create a user account, any Gmail or Google Apps account will work, and copy and paste a short script onto every page of your website you wish to track. Content management systems make this easier by using their internal settings or with the help of plugins. As soon as data begins coming in, it is all collected into a database and made available to you in a number of ways. You can review this data and quickly determine how visitors are finding your website, where they are navigating to or from your website, which pages receive the most hits, which pages are viewed the longest, how many first-time visitors versus repeat visitors are viewing your website, and even how many visitors use specific operating systems, mobile devices, screen resolutions, browsers, etc. You can also view a list of visitors' IP addresses and their general location, country. This information can often help you focus on more popular features of your website or determine if an area of your site requires a redesign or additional attention to increase traffic. If you have a YouTube channel, you can even provide your Google Analytics ID in your account settings there so that similar statistics can help you track the viewership of your posted videos. You can also use your analytical information to convince potential advertisers, supporters, or donors that there is a high probability of a return on their investment. Total number of views or visitors a month can be compared to traditional advertising methods.